Hi students, good morning. Welcome to online class of New Vivekananda Convent Higher Secondary School. And today I will discuss an important topic of English grammar, that is determiners. Dear students, do you know what is determiners? A determiner is a word used before a noun or noun phrase to show what or who it refers to. So look here, determiners. A determiner is a word used before a noun or noun phrases to show what or who it refers to. Look here, what is determiner? A determiner is a word used before a noun, noun or noun phrases to show what or who it refers to. And you all know there are different types of determiners, but today I only discuss few determiners, and today I will discuss only the uses of some, any, little, a little, the little, few, a few, and the few. Look here. Determiners. Some, any, few, a few, the few. Number three. Little, a little, the little. So today's discussing point is the uses of some, any, few, a few, the few, little, a little, the little. Now one by one I will discuss about the uses of different types of determiners. First of all, uses of some, any. Uses of some, any. Some, any, they are used before plural, countable noun, plural countable noun or uncountable noun. So dear students, some and any, both, they are used before plural, countable noun or uncountable noun. So how to use some or any? At first, where do we use some? Uses of some. Yes, uses of some. Use number one, in affirmative sentences. Yes, some is used mainly in affirmative sentences. Look here, as for example, she bought some honey. Yes, some. They ate some mangoes. Look here, example one, example two. Two examples are given to you. Both the sentences are affirmative sentences, and I have already told you some is used in affirmative sentences. She bought some honey. Honey is uncountable noun, and I have already told you used before uncountable noun and countable noun also. Mangoes, plural countable noun. So before these nouns, there is the use of some. Next, use number two. In offers and request, some is also used in the case of offers and request. As for example, would you like some wine? There is the use of some. Will you have some more tea? Do you want some more ice cream? So, three examples are given to you. Would you like some wine? And an offer, a request. Will you have some more tea? Do you want some more ice cream? So, I have already discussed the uses of some. At first, some is used in affirmative sentences, and the second use is in offers and request. Now, I will discuss the uses of any. Any, look here. Number one, in negative sentences, any is used mainly in negative sentences. Look here. They have not played any matches. Yes, they have not played any matches. Any negative sentence, there is the use of not. They have not played any matches. There were not any mangoes in the market today. So, dear students, any is mainly used in negative sentences, like they have not played any matches, there are not any mangoes in the market today. Yes, then use number two. In questions, in questions, any is used in questions means interrogative sentence. Look here, example number one. Do you have any relatives in America? Yes, do you have any relatives in America? So there is the use of any. The sentence is there is a note of interrogation, so questions. Have you got any money? Yes, any. Have you got any money? This is also an interrogative sentence. A question is there. So both the sentences, they are interrogative sentence. So in interrogative sentence also we use any. Now I have already discussed the uses of some, any, and now I am going to discuss the uses of few, a few, and the few. Look here. Few, a few, the few. Few, a few, and the few, they all are used before plural countable nouns. They are used before plural countable nouns. So few, a few, the few, they all are used before plural uncountable noun. But where do we use few and where do we use a few? And where do we use the few? How to identify? What are the differences among few, a few, and the few? Look here. At first, I will discuss about few. Uses of few. Yes. Few refers to a small number. Few refers to a small number as against many. Yes. Few refers to a small number as against many. It has negative meaning. And almost nothing. Yes. Few refers to a small number as against many. It has negative meaning and almost nothing. As for example, few men know him around this place as he is new at this place. Look here. Few men, there is the use of few. Few men know him around this place as he is new at this place. Few. So, few refers to a small number as against many. It has negative meaning and almost nothing. Example 2. Since they are aware few boys in the class, so the teacher went back. Look here. Since there are few boys, few means almost none, so the teacher went back. So students, I think you all have understood the uses of few. Next, the uses of a few. look here. A few refers to small number as against none. A small difference is there. A few refers to small number as against none. As against none, it has some positive meanings. Positive meaning and at least something. Look here. A few refers to small number as against none. It has a positive meaning and at least something. As for example, a few. Only a few Indian don't respect their culture. Yes, only a few Indians don't respect their culture. Yes, a few means at least some persons are there who disrespect their culture. Yes, example number 2. I have a few cows that give me milk. Look here. I have a few cows. At least few cows are there. They are giving some milk. At least something. So, uses of few, you all have understood. Now, I will discuss the few. The uses of the few. Yes. Look here. The few is used before countable nouns. Plural countable nouns. Plural countable nouns and small in number but everything. It is used always at the starting of a sentence. Yes, the few. The few is used before plural countable nouns and small in number but everything. Whatever there are but everything, and used always at the starting of a sentence. Look here, as for example. Yes, the few friends. Yes, friends is plural countable noun. The few friends I had helped me most. The few at the starting of the sentence. The few ornaments, the few ornaments she had were stolen. So, I have given two examples, the uses of the few. The few friends is plural countable noun. So before friend, there is the use of the few. Why? Because little, because small in number but everything. He has few friends. He has few friends, but all of his friends help him most. Yes, a few ornaments she had were stolen. So I have already discussed all about the rules of uses of few, a few, and the few. And last of all, I will discuss the uses of little, a little, and the little. Look here. Yes. Little. A little, the little. Dear students, little, a little, and the little, they all are used before uncountable nouns. So, but they are three. Where do we use little, and where do we use a little and the little? So what are the differences among them? So look here. Look, at first I will discuss the uses of little. Little. Uses of little. Yes, it refers to a small amount. It refers to a small amount, and it has negative meaning, and almost nothing. Look here. Little. Little refers to a small amount. Small amount, very small in amount, and it has negative meaning and almost nothing. As for example, little knowledge is a dangerous thing. Yes, little knowledge is a dangerous thing. Example 1, example 2. She has little love for her husband, so she always disobeys him. Look here. Little knowledge is a dangerous thing. Little means almost nothing. And she has little love. She has little love, so she always disrespect or disobeys her husband. So I have already discussed the uses of little. Now I will discuss the uses of a little. A little difference is there. Yes. The uses of a little. It refers to a small amount, as against none. It refers to a small amount as against none. It has a positive meaning and at least something. Yes, uses of a little. It refers to a small amount as against none. It has a positive meaning and at least something. For example, at least something. You can learn swimming if you have a little patience. Yes, a little. Patience is uncountable noun. So before uncountable noun, there is the use of a little, and at least some patience you needed to learn swimming. Example number two. You can master English with a little efforts. Yes, a little efforts. Efforts. Yes, efforts is uncountable noun, and before uncountable noun there is the use of a little. And if you want to be a master in English, you need some patience. So at least something you needed. So there is the use of a little. And now last of all, I will discuss the uses of the little. Yes. The little is used before uncountable noun. Uncountable noun. It is small in amount but everything. Yes, just like the uses of the few is used before countable nouns, but the little is used before uncountable noun, but the uses are the same. Look here, it is a small in amount but everything. It always used at the starting of a sentence. Yes, always used, always used at the starting of a sentence. Look here, for example, the little hope we had was lost. They have little hope, but the little hope also lost. It means everything. Yes, was lost. The little time we had, the little time we had was lost. Look here. Here, time is also uncountable noun, and hope is also uncountable noun. So, both the nouns, before the nouns, we use, I use the little, the little, the little time. We have little time, but the little time also lost. The little hope, they have little hope, but the little hope was also lost. So, in this way, today, I have already discussed all about the uses of some, any, few, a few, the few, little, a little, the little, and what is the definition of determiners. So, dear students, I think you all have understood well. So, that's all. Thanks. Have a nice day.